to me, if you didn't mention me in the Guinness Book of Records, on it. I will try to find a way to insert myself. Because I did it without expectation.
Well, PETER OBI in that interview said he may actually be correct when he claims that his name deserves to be in the Guinness World Records. Don't forget that people's names don't always make it into the Guinness World Records for only altruistic reasons. So it depends on which angle he is coming from. If the idea is to put his name on the Guinness Book of World Records for causing Nigerians the most hardship, untold hardship. Of course, he's spot on, and I will totally agree with him because his reforms are not achieving what they are meant to achieve, Dr. Abati.
Well, as they say, in circumstances like this.
Of course.
What do you expect Mr. PETER OBI to say? He was one of the major presidential candidates in the 2023 general election, which assured you Bola Ahmed Tinubu of the All Progressives Congress won. If spokespersons of the president were to respond, they would say, oh, it's sour grapes. Mr. PETER OBI is condemning the president because he lost out to him, not just at the polls, but also all the way to the Supreme Court. However, the counterpoint that we always make is that it is the job of the opposition to criticize the government. And that what the opposition this time around has shown, whether it is Mr. PETER OBI or Waziri Atiku Abubakar, they are beginning to show a real confidence to hold the sitting government at the center to task and to raise questions and to ask questions. And it's not just a matter of opinion, it's also a matter of perception. Mr. PETER OBI is saying, so far, we can assess the Tinubu administration. There are some people, I think we had a guest today also, who was saying, well, it's too early in the day. Yeah. Let us give them a whole year. That was Lai Omotola, right? Yeah. Let's give them a whole year before we begin to assess. But the same government themselves have started assessing themselves. President Tinubu has directed that a committee of 140 persons be put together to assess the performance of the ministers. What I find curious there is why you will need 140 persons to assess the performance of 46 ministers when it is so clear that some people in that cabinet are passengers. Yes. For some of them are so unknown, are so absent that Nigerians don't even know that they are ministerial appointments. There's another group that is perpetually putting their feet in their mouths. And each time they open their mouths like this, they will cause problems. Either they are quoting wrong statistics or they are saying things they know nothing about. Not to talk of the other crowd that have been implicated in all kinds of things. So the assessment has begun. And those who are saying, let us wait for till it is 1 year. That 1 year is almost here.
It's here.
This is February, right? February is a few days from here. And then, of course, you know, the 1 year will be here. So the question is, what would the administration be remembered for, be known for 1 year after? We used to talk about 100 days in office. Now some people have moved the goalposts to 1 year. Okay, the 1 year will soon be here, and we will take a look at the reforms. We will take a look at what has been done with infrastructure. We will take a look at what has been done even in terms of the style of governance. And we will take a look at some of the key things that the administration has done. I'm sure we have not heard the last from Mr. PETER OBI. He will speak again and again. And I hope nobody will be funny enough to go and issue a statement, the kind of statement with which I started. That, oh, it is sour grapes, Mr. PETER OBI, because the spokespersons, you know, to be seen to be working.
Right.
The standard practice is to abuse anybody who raises a point.
Yeah.
As for Guinness Book of World Records, well, I don't know, because you have to apply to get into the Guinness Book of World Records. And I don't see the Nigerian president going to apply for any kind of notation in the Guinness Book of World Records.
But of course, PETER OBI and of course Atiku Abubakar are the strong opposition. Yeah. You know, PETER OBI has a way with words, and you know, it's just showing how difficult it is to live at this time in Nigeria. Even just mentioning the security situation, I believe even over the weekend, Dr. Abati, we were discussing that story of the Middle Belt Forum. Yeah. I believe these people are called the Funam Group. They had brought out a statement threatening fire and brimstone because they arrested, or they claim that they arrested the president of the Meeti Ala Kotohori group.
Bello Bodejo.
Bello Bodejo.
Yes.
Which the DSS had said that they don't have in their custody. I mean, we are seeing economic hardship. We are seeing insecurity. We are seeing people being killed on a daily basis in Nigeria. I mean, what's your take on that statement, that Funam statement, before we move?
Well, so in terms of the statement and coming out to say that, you know, hailing fire and brimstone, I think it's important that to link it with the state of the economy. Yeah. Because we had talked about the Meeti Ala situation last week, and we had said that it is an admittance of failure when different groups decide to set up their vigilante groups in order to address insecurity situations. Now, where we have statements from groups and threats here and there, it speaks to a total breakdown of law and order, a state of anarchy almost, where groups of people are threatening to take matters into their own hands, and also raises up the question that where then is the president of Meeti Ala? Mm-hmm. If security agencies are saying that he's not with them, their groups are saying, oh, he's with them and they should release him, then where are we? And unfortunately, there's a lack of trust in the, and I'm sorry to say, lack of trust in statements made like that, because in the past, we have seen situations where the ball is passed from one person to the other saying, right, I don't have, and it's not quite the situation. So I believe that security agencies, whether it's the DSS, the police, or anyone who's responsible, ought to give a true sense or a statement as to what is really going on. Now, as to where he is. But very importantly, Oji, talking about sour grapes and what the opposition, a member of the opposition in the person of Mr. PETER OBI has said, what he has said is clearly the truth, because you can measure it. You know, Rufai would often say empirical data. It is clear that a lot of Nigerians have been plunged further into poverty with some of the reforms and policy direction of this particular administration. And so I'm hoping that this, rather than coming out preparing a speech to counter what has been said, they should go back to the drawing board and reevaluate some of the policies and announcements that they have made.
Yes.
Where there's a mistake made, or perhaps you see that a policy direction isn't favorable, it's important to go back to the drawing board.
Absolutely.
Don't stick to the guns and say, no, this is the way. The only people who seem to be praising the efforts in its entirety are foreign organizations, IMF, World Bank, you know, the United States. But the Nigerian people, including the people who are in the president's constituency, are saying that they are hungry, that they need food to eat. We see fuel price has gone up, businesses are closing down, and so these are certain concerns. And finally, just to mention some of the ministers that Dr. Abati alluded to, because we ourselves, we don't need to be part of the 140 people to judge the act. Where's the Minister of, Steel Development? Where's the Minister of State, Agriculture and Food Security? Where is the Minister of Tourism? There are certain ministers who have been very quiet since the administration begun. So just a few questions there.
Let me just quickly read number 6 of that statement that they released. And this is from Funam. And the person who wrote this statement wrote it on July, or two people actually, January 24th. And this is a call to the DSS and all the security forces. The person's name is Umar Amir Shehu and Badu Salisu Amadu. They're saying that if the Plateau people don't leave Plateau State, that there's going to be jihad. Number 6, we call on non-Fulani people to vacate Plateau State, Kaduna, and Benue States if they are not ready to live under the inevitable jihad, which will eventually be all over Nigeria.
Well, this is where we have found ourselves.
Yes.
Whereby a group, Funam, by the way, means Fulani Nationalist Movement. And it's unfortunate that up to this moment, the two gentlemen have not come forward to say their names are being used in vain, and it is not their deed, or that they did not issue the statement. For anyone to come up and say, we're declaring a jihad in every town, every village, every part of Nigeria, that in itself is an action against the Nigerian state. It's an act of provocation an insensitive, an incitement.
Absolutely.
Because they are also saying Fulanis in every part of Nigeria should join the jihad against other Nigerians.
Unacceptable.
I mean,
very important.
You have called out appropriately the Department of State Services not to allow people to engage in this kind of behavior.
Well, all right. We'll